What's going on, y'all? JT here with a quick unboxing and look at the all-new Arrma Typhon 3S version 3. Now, I'm not going to go too in-depth in this unboxing because a lot of this stuff is the same thing I've talked about in my RC updates and then the unboxing on the Granite and then also on the Big Rock as well. So you guys know that they added a couple of features and stuff to this as well. So I did get this from NZ Hobbies. There is a link down below in the description, nzhobbies.com. And if you're local, I say go by there and check him out and see what he's got, because he's got a lot of stuff actually in his store and stuff as well. So he's got a lot of products. Arrma, Axio, he's got some tracks and stuff, and he's got a lot of different things in there. So you guys go check him out if you can. You get a couple minutes. So anyway, let me go ahead, and get this unboxed and open up real quick. And y'all know we got to do it. Smell and look of a brand new RC car. You got to love it. You got to love it. So I'll get this out in just a second. I do wish that Arrma had changed something on this as far as the color scheme, because for the other cars, for the Granite, they changed the colors on those. For the Sentinel, they changed the body and color on that a little bit as well. And for the Big Rock, they made a big change. So this was the only one of that series that they did not change the body color on. I wish they would have did maybe a lightish gray or a black or orange or something like that, but they didn't do it. So anyway, I'm going to get this pulled out real quick. We'll take a quick look at it. All right, got all that out the way. So now I'll eventually do a comparison of the three that I have between this Typhon, the Granite, and then also the Big Rock. And one day I'll get them all out there and I will get them running. So I do believe, and you guys can quote me on this, that Arrma actually got this right with this particular version. Now, I say that because with this particular version, you do get an adjustable motor mount. So there is no more fixed motor mount positions for pinion gears or anything in there. And I do believe that the sweet spot for this was going to be about a 16 or 17 tooth pinion gear, but we'll get it out and we'll get it running and stuff and see as well. But with that, the better radio as well, get better response, better reception, everything with this radio, and distance everything. And then also with the better servo, I believe this will be very, very, very good. I mean, it'll be competitive if you kind of take it to a track, to a local track. That is, I'm not going to, y'all don't quote me. Oh, I went to world, if more world championships, not lost. JTRC said it, but I think you'll be fine or have some fun. If you go out there and you just went to a local track and try to be competitive with it. I don't know. Some of the track rules may be different because of this is kind of a 3S kind of setup. So you may have to change it out and put a 4S system in it, but it can possibly handle a 4S system in it without any issues or problems, I believe, because stock out the box, it is going to run 50 miles per hour or 50 miles per hour plus, and we'll put that to the test this Saturday. But everything else, like I said, the tire compound from the one I've had before, that was fine, and the handling stuff was fine before as well. It did need a better servo in it, which they did with this one, a stronger, faster servo, which they did with this version. And it did need stock out the box, a better radio as well. And some issues with as far as the shocks and stuff leaking, I believe that's completely been addressed, because with my Big Rock and my Granite, I haven't had one issue with the shocks leaking or anything like that. And I put them both to the skate park and did some jumps and all that stuff. But although it was on 2S, it didn't matter, because before we were having leaky shocks. I mean, sometimes some people were doing unboxings and their shocks were leaking there. So I do believe that they got that right. So I think that stock out the box, if you guys were thinking about an 8-scale buggy, but you didn't really want to spend the money on and all that, I'd recommend getting this, because you can do a little bit more with it than it is stock out the box for it. But anyway, taking a quick look at this, you guys know that it comes with the new radio, SLT3 radio. This is a 3-channel radio. Third channel is going to be there. It does have some of your basic trims and stuff on there, and it uses 4AAs. Fits nice in the hand, and so far, so good. This radio has been good. It's been good and responsive. And it just has a different feel than some of the previous radios that came with these kits. Next to the Tactic radio, you guys know I love Tactic radio. So as far as goodies go, you get basic instructions, but there are no stickers. So I'm not sure if they're not just giving stickers out anymore with the 3S models. It would be nice to get some extra stickers in case you replace the body or buy another body and paint it, but there aren't any stickers in here either. I already looked earlier, but you do get some tools and stuff to work on the car, and they are including now, because I believe when I got my first one, version 1, a long time ago, they did not have anything to remove these wheels off of here. They just gave you this red tool up in here, but now they're actually giving you something to remove that. So that's good as well. And looking at the car just in general, tire compound has been very good, especially for a ready to run 8-scale buggy that's running on 10-scale electronics. You won't have any problems with that. Now, if you start trying to put a lot of power and speed on these, or if you take these tires and wheels and you put them on a regular 8-scale buggy, I put them on my Typhon, my 6S one, and I did run and actually end up tearing them because of the extra weight. So these tires and wheels would be perfect for this car, or if you put it on your big rock or something like that, because of they can handle that particular weight with it. So I do know that from experience with this. And real quick, looking at the layout of the inside of it. So the layout looks pretty similar, pretty familiar to what you guys have seen before, especially with the big rock, with it having the longer extended chassis. There's just some differences with this to make this more of a buggy like, but it does have the upgraded speed controller on it with catback on. It does have the new Arrma motor in it. And then it also has a fan over the heatsink as well. So all those are nice little touches to it. And it does have these easy pull tabs now that you can just pull this up and pull that out as well. So there's a couple of things as far as like the chassis design. They did redo the front end so that rocks and stuff aren't getting caught up in there. And thus far, I haven't had any problems with the granite or the big rock with that. Now with this particular body, the way it is constructed, with this big opening here, you will get stuff back here. So stuff will fly up in there. So I'll probably get a dust cover or something to put up in there. Or maybe I might construct something to put back there. But we'll see. But they did toughen the chassis up and stuff like that as well. So that, like I said, this is going to be kind of a quick unboxing of this, because I've unboxed two of the other newer versions of this. And those have performed well, and I do believe this is probably going to be the best performing one out of all four of them. I haven't gotten a Sentin or anything like that, but the Sentin was the fastest when I tested all four of them before, because the Sentin does come with a 22 pinion gear. Even though the tires are a little bit smaller, the Sentin was the fastest of the previous four. But this one handled a little bit better. But the Sentin, of course, when you flipped it over, it kind of flipped back over because it had a short course body. But I believe, like I said, I know I'm beating a dead horse. They probably got this 100% right now with the faster servo, the better radio, and a couple of things, especially with that adjustable motor mount, because I will be probably doing about a 16 or 17 tooth pinion gear in there. So anyway, guys, I will not waste too much more time on this. You guys have seen unboxings of this and before, and you guys seen unboxings of the newer stuff as well. So I really want to get this out and get this running. They do have some races and stuff coming up this weekend, so I'm going to try to go by there. I probably won't be able to race because I haven't been racing on a track in a while, but it would be cool to kind of get this out there and be competitive and race with those other guys. But I haven't been to a track in a while, and the track layout is different, but I may try to get out there and run a couple of laps on the track if I can get out there and if the weather's permitting, because it's supposed to be kind of cloudy and periodic showers throughout the weekend. So we'll see, but I'll definitely be trying to get this on that track out there as well, and kind of seeing how this handles, and then running it in other areas to take it over to the BMX track. It's going to be interesting to run this there. So anyway, guys, don't forget to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching.